Rav, Rabotai, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for coming once again to the Gate of Trust. Shar HaBitachon, Chovat HaLevavot. We're going to speak about a lot of faith and trust in the Almighty God. Our class tonight is sponsored by the Yosupov family, Mona Rachamim and Mrs. Riva Yosupov, that the Almighty God will give them a long life, and a healthy life, and a happy life, successful life, Be'ezrat Hashem. That is always going to remain between of them, Ahava, Ve'achva, Shalom, Ve'reut, Be'ezrat Hashem. And may this year they're going to dance for the wedding of Chana, Chana, Bat, Riva, Be'ezrat Hashem, Nishma, Kol Sashon, Ve'kol Simcha, Kol Chatan, Ve'kol Kala, Ve'nomar Amin. Our Divrei Torah is the new Nishmat Aisha Keshara, Aisha Keshara, Shinifterah B'Shem Dolanam Marat, Chosni Bat Yeshua, Ruach Hashem Techana Megan Eden, Tiyeh Nishmata Tzura B'Tzor Chaim. Morav Rabotai, ladies and gentlemen, tonight is Yotet Kislev. Yotet Kislev is a very special night. I will share with you a few words before, and then we're going to get into our topics. This is a beautiful, beautiful topic that I saw. But just before, the Tzemach Tzedek cried, that the greatest love, and I spoke about it already a few times, but listen to the beautiful word of the Tzemach Tzedek. The Tzemach Tzedek cried in the Yom Yom. Yom Yom is a daily message of Chabad that they have in a daily basis. And he write this way, the greatest love that a human being can have, ahava, that you don't want anything except God. If you remember one time in Yom Kippur, I told you that Admor Zaken, the founder of Hasidut, the one that was released in Yotet Kislev. And Gabriel Admor Zaken said, "Shehitzlachti lifol biYotet Kislev, mashiyom haKippurim osei," meaning, I succeed to manage that in this night, in these days, anything that a person will ask, exactly the same like Yom HaKippurim, God will answer to him. Yotet Kislev is a very special and a holy night. It's a very special and a holy days. They call it Rosh Hashanah leChasidut. Chasidim wishing each other. Ktiva veChatima Tova. I wish today somebody, Ktiva veChatima Tova. He said, Rabbi, we are on the way to Hanukkah, not to Rosh Hashanah. We are very fast. I said, no. Among Hasidim today and tonight is Rosh Hashanah leChasidim. Is the beginning of the year in Hasidut. And Hasidut brought many things to this world. Many gifts happened in the last 200 to 250 years. That's from the time of the Baal Shem Tov. But as Moshe can write, that anything that you're going to ask in these times, you're going to be fulfilled. And listen to one of the uniqueness items that maybe we have to take. We are so busy in our life, we are so busy that this world become a business world. When I say a business world, anything that a person is doing is always negotiation behind. A person tell you good morning, you have to ask yourself, what did you want from me? Because nature-wise, nobody tell you good morning if it doesn't need anything from you. Why does he care? When a person asks, how are you doing? And suddenly he have time to listen to you, most likely he wants something. Either he's building, how do we call him? The builders. Either he's building something for the future, or either now he's going to cash it. But he's always going to cash it. You see, Gabriel, the Tzemach Tzedek writes that the greatest love that a person can have to the Almighty God, Mrs. Bella, is what? Admor HaZaken, a minute before he died, and listen to the word he said, Ribono Shel Olam, Eni Rotzeh Gan Eden Shelcha, Ve'eni Rotzeh Olam Haba Shelcha, Ki'im Otcha Levad. The Almighty God, I don't want your Olam Haba, and I don't want your Gan Eden. All what I want is you. Wow. You know what a love is that? Every mitzvah that we're doing, and this is maybe emunah v'bitachon. You know, when we come into this class, and I told you many times, and I will prove you even tonight, that if you're going to have this faith in the Almighty God, you're going to see miracles. And people come to the class, this class, maybe the most important class, not in Queens, in the whole United States. BJCC, Yud Minyan Totfro, a place to be. A place that consider home. A place that's changing people, mind and heart. Ladies and gentlemen, listen to this. But above having, is always a question in mind, if I'm going to keep Shabbat, what's the benefits? If I will give maaser, what's the benefits? So the rabbi said, if I'm going to give maaser, I'm going to become rich. If I'm going to keep Shabbat during the week, business is going to go beautiful, right? If I'm going to keep Torah mitzvot, I'm going to have benefits. If I will send my children to yeshiva, they're going to become good children. So it's a great benefit. They're all right. By the way, they're all right. If I will eat kosher, I'm going to be more healthy. Everybody's right. But Hasidut came to the world and said, we have to ask you to raise a little. To stop being selfish. To stop being selfish. If every mitzvah that you're doing is question behind this, what I'm gaining, you are a selfish man. This is not considered to be love. You don't love God. You love yourself. I said, maybe last week or 2 weeks ago, when a Kotzke Rebbe saw somebody eat fish. And you know, sometimes you eat good steak or good ushpelon or good fish, and you said, wow, I love this fish, right? Tell me that this is you, that you really love the fish. You know, the Kotzke Rebbe saw this guy ate the fish. And you know what the Rebbe said? If this is what you're doing to the one that you love, I don't want to imagine what you're doing to the one that you don't like. You kill the fish, you take him out of the water, you kill them, you chop him, you take the skin. You're such an aggressive person. And he's your lover, he's the one that you love. What are you going to do to the guy that you don't like? We don't like the fish, we don't like the shawarma, we don't like the steak. We like the taste, meaning we like the benefits that we get from it. Maybe when we do mitzvot, it's a bad time. That we can ask, after so many years, being in this community, that at least one mitzvah, or even more, we're going to do for the sake of God. Hashem, I love you. I'm doing Bikur Cholim not because I'm hoping that one of the sick person will give me the Yerusha, the will, or maybe he's going to die, and maybe the family, and maybe here. No. We become business world. I know that today to say I'm a businessman is like something, wow, he's a businessman, wow, respect. Businessman meaning I'm a very selfish man. And everything that I'm doing is always the same question. What I'm gaining? I don't know. Realistic-wise, you have to be ashamed when you said, I'm a businessman. Not because, God forbid, you're stealing. You're not stealing. You're doing honest business. Because businessman meaning I'm doing your business. Anything that I'm doing is always selfish reason. Queen, did you ever heard it? Come, that Morazakim, the first Chabad Rebbe, the one that indicate Yotet Kislev and said, maybe it's a bad time to do something for the sake of God. Hashem Yitbarach. Even rabbis that bring in other people in teshuvah, and their mind is, if we study Torah and Olam Haba, I'm going to have a great Olam Haba. Again, selfish. Hashem, the Almighty God, I don't want your Olam Haba. I don't need your Gan Eden. I don't want your Gan Eden. What did I want is, I want you. And only you. Wow. What a beautiful ways. What a beautiful ways, huh, Gabriel? This is one.
What does that mean, I want you?
You meaning I'm doing it because I'm in love with you. Not because I'm getting any benefits. And you know how you know that you love God and you don't get any benefits? When something is going wrong, when you fulfill, when you keep Shabbat and business after, is that going so great? You give 10% and not only that you didn't become rich, business is going so tough and you're losing money, and you said, God, I'm still having faith on you. Abraham Avinu literally loved God. You know how I know that he loved God? Because he passed 10 most difficult tests in a human being life. No human being have the ability to pass such a test and still be successful. This is the meaning to love you. Love you with your deficiency. Love you with your obstacle. I love you. This is one. Moreover, Rabotai, listen to this. A Rebbe Maharash was writing this way. The pasuk said, "Lo yiten leolam mot latzadik." Meaning, Daniel. Lo yiten leolam mot latzadik. Meaning, Nadir, what's the meaning? Lo yiten leolam mot latzadik. Leolam mot latzadik. God will never give a righteous man to fall down. He will never give him to fall down. Spatially in Parnassah. Spatially in Parnassah. So the only question that we have remain is, how come so many people that have, that they are righteous, that they do business in the right way, that they do everything right, why they have difficulty? Why people every day fighting for their Parnassah? If the Pasuk said so clear that God will never let a righteous man to fall down, why we see so much tzaddikim that their parnasa is difficult? And they never stole, and they never lie, and still they're fighting for the money, and if they get $3,000 to $4,000 a month, it's a miracle. Listen to the answer. Liyot ke'abitachon eno ke'debay lemaveh. She'arektiv ashlech al Hashem me'afcha, והוא יחלק לך. דהיינו שזה תנאי. אבל כשאינו בוטח כדבאי, מפסיק השבע בפרנסה. ואם היה בוטח בשם, התברך לעשות תורתו קבע, ומלאכתו הרי, היה מסתכל הרבה יותר. והיה מתקיים בו הפסוק, אשליך על השם יהפך, והוא יחלק לך. לכן העצה היא יוצא לכל אחד מישראל. נפתוח בשם התברך, שהוא התברך שתח לו עזרתו. מקודש בפרנסה נצרכת לו, והתעסק במקח וממכר באמונה לעשות מסחר קרוב לשכר, ולא להרבות במסחר מרבים, כי זהו נגד הביטחון, כי היד השם תקצר להושיע, אין ברע ואין במעט הסחור. וואו, we come into a class of faith and trust. And the Rebbe Rashab extended this way. Dr. Daniel, listen to that, Dr. Daniel. You know why we have issue in פרנסה? Not because we don't work enough. Unfortunately, in our days in life, we become workaholic. Some people, they are proud. Kvod Rav, I'm working 18 hours. I heard a guy that came to me and said, Rabbi, I'm working 25 hours. I said, I don't know, if I remember, it's only 24 hours. He said, yes, Rabbi, I wake up 1 hour before. Listen to that. I mean, people compete. How many hours they're working in order to make money? Somebody got the message. Right? Now people compete, how many hours they're working? I tell you, you're wrong. One of the solid proof is, the more money you have, the less hours you're working. I don't know if you realize, the multimillionaire guys, they're not the ones that are working so hard. They're the ones that come into the office 2 or 3 hours, and flying all day long to have vacations, most of the times. Most of the years they're on a vacation, and they come and just make a decision on the phone. Buy, sell, sell, buy. So the amount of hours have nothing to do with the amount of money. This is fact. But you can tell me, but Rabbi, they teach me in a public school or in Princeton or Yale that hours, if you're making in hours, $20 an hour, and you're working 5 hours, or you're working 10 hours, it's better to work, right? That's what they teach me. They also teach me that if you don't give charity, you have more money in your pocket, right? This is what they teach. 100% they're right. But you know why we have issue in Parnassa? Because our faith is not so strong. If a person will believe that Hashem Yitbarach is the one that given the Parnassa, you're going to see miracles in your life. Miracles. How do you know that you believe that Hashem Yitbarach? How do you know in actions that you believe that God is the one? First of all, doing honest business. Honest business. Second, don't make so much money. But Rabbi, I need to make so much for rainy days. What's going to happen in 20 years from now? My children. Lack of faith. This is what we call in Arabic, lack of faith in God. In English. You have no faith in Hashem. Because Ayad Hashem Tekzar, the hand of God is so short that He cannot provide you the parnasah of today. You don't trust Hashem to give you the parnasah tomorrow, that you have to work so many days in order to have saving. Righteous people never had a saving account. They had only checking account. Saving in a way is lack of trust in God. I know that today you're going to look at me, Rabbi, what are you talking? I mean, everybody have saving account. I opened my saving account. And I saw that I was so excited. I came to my wife, I said, Shlomit, you're not going to believe, I checked the saving account and the checking account. Checking account was $26, and saving was $42 cash. And I asked my wife, what exactly are we planning to do with this huge amount of money? So she asked me, I said, don't worry. The big amount of money, the $42, we're going to send to Switzerland for our grandchildren, and the $26 we're going to leave for the next 2 years. And Baruch Hashem, thank God, every month, God provided me the money to pay the bills, to pay the tuition of my children, and to pay the money that I owed, and to pay the mortgage. And thank God, nobody's knocking on the door, and I can answer the phone every day, 24/7, 6. How many business people that can answer the phones every day? How many times you check, oh, this guy owed the money, I'm not answering. No. 6 months, I didn't pay him already. I took some, I put him in black. Right? Gentlemen, the guy that have $26 in the bank can answer every moment his phone. Yes. Because thank God, Baruch Hashem, I'm never late. Ask me how, every month is a new miracle. You hear that? Having a faith in God, it's always in the end of the days. How do you know that you have a faith in God? When you're not working to worry about what's going to be tomorrow. Not only that, doing honest business, and gentlemen, I will tell you more. I hope that you're going to feel good that you came tonight, because one of the proof that you have a faith in the Almighty God is to come to Shiur Torah. It cannot be that coming to Shiur Torah, you're going to lose money because of it. Cannot happen. You hear that? Coming, how that Chazal said? Ase Toratcha keva u'melachto harai. Nadir, nobody can lose money from studying Torah. No one can lose money from studying. Yes, it's a small obstacle, it's a small challenge, but it's a small one. Because when you study Torah, you open the gate of trust. You open the gate of heaven upon you. And it's just a question of time until God will show you that the gate is open. And then you're going to see unlimited wealth. Like I told you, it's not how many hours you work in. It's how much mazad you have in these times. You see, it was a son of a rabbi. The rabbi's name is Rabbi Menachem Mendel Miraminov, was a very holy rabbi. The son was some people, they have bad mazal. He had a bad mazal money-wise. He was a big Talmid Chacham, but money-wise, he had nothing to eat. And his father, Mrs. Bella, his father, every month used to give him to support him. After so many years, he still needs support. Usually, you're helping your children, they get married, father, go find yourself. Find Parnassah. The father used to give him 3 zeuvim, 3 coins of gold every month. It was exactly good enough for 50% of his need. 50% of his need. His father used to give him, let's say, you need 4,000, 2,000 every month. So one day the son came to the Abba, to his father, and said, Abba, I know that you have money. And if you give me three coins, if you give me 2,000, why you cannot give me 4,000 and finish it? I mean, if you're already helping me, let's do it right. Why are you helping half away? I mean, some people, they come to you, you're asking help, the guy give you half. He's like, how bad is when a person pour in water for you and he pour only half? I mean, if you already pour, put water. Why are you putting only half? You're saving on my account, but the water in America is in crisis. In Israel, I understand, but in America, they have enough. So he said, Abba, if you already given me, why you don't give full? Give me the 4,000. What you gonna answer, Kohen? What you gonna answer? Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, she'akol niya bedvaro. What you gonna answer? It's a good question. And the father had the money. No, no, every month.
Yeah.
Every month you're going to give him, he's going to come every month. Every month he's going to come. He needs 4,000. You don't give him 40,000, you give him 4,000. What are you going to answer? Your son is coming to you and asking you, Abba, why you don't give me the full amount? Why you give me only half? What are you going to answer? It's a good question, right? You have the money to help your children. You give in already 50%. Why you don't give 100%? Mrs. Bella, what's going to be your answer? What is that, Mrs. What's that, Mrs. Rima?
She said, be happy with what I give you.
Okay.
you want.
This is a Bukharian answer or what? Beautiful answer, but you know, you're Ima. Ima, Abba, why you don't help me? I need money to pay my children. I'm not asking luxury. I'm not asking DVD or something, no, no, no. I'm asking necessary items to pay tuition for my children. No, you are my grand, the children is coming. Babo, and how do you say, Ima? Safta?
Bibi
and Babo. And I'm coming to you, and the children look like that, so innocent. Why you don't give us all the money? What a question, huh? Listen to the answer of the rabbi to his own child. And this rabbi Mirenu, had the money. He said, Ana lo aviv, his father answered, Im iten lecha kedei kol parnasatcha, eton mimcha chalila et midat ha-bitachon b'Hashem. Wow. Gentlemen, this is not business world. Say thank you very much for what I give you. No. This is a business answer. This is a spirituality answer. If I will give you everything that you need, you're going to stop having a faith in God. And it's going to be my fault. Now you have faith in me. And I cannot take from you, the faith in Hashem Yitbarach. So I'm helping you half, the other half having a faith in Hashem. I want you to have bitachon and emunah and the Almighty God. You hear that, gentlemen? If it's anything that we come in here to work, if a person wants to know why it's difficult in Parnassah, why we fighting so much? Because our emunah and bitachon is weak. The strongest that our emunah and bitachon will be. Now, how do I know that your emunah and bitachon is strong? Dr. Avraham, how do you know that? When you, God forbid, not you, you're always going to gain business. But when a customer left you to your own competition, and not only that you don't get upset, you're actually helping him to give him some advice what to do. The other doctor is calling you and said, Dr. Avraham, this patient can do. He said, yes, definitely. You need to do this and this and this stiff. And you do it with a smile. Wow, what a faith, huh? What a faith. When you want to buy a house so badly, or you want to buy a building so badly, and the deal didn't pass through, and you are right away fuming, fighting, and you blessing the guy that ruined the deal, and you bless his father and his grandfather, Ahmad Konam, and you blessing the whole family. When I say blessing, I'm not talking about blessing, because you are upset. You have lack of faith in God. Ladies and gentlemen, Hashem is running the world. Nothing that happened in our life happened for no reason. Everything have a reason. Wait a second. Having a faith in God that what happened good for you. So this is the introduction. Now we're getting into our class. And I saw it from Rabbi Jacobson. It was amazing ideas. It's three questions that a person have to answer to himself. It's three questions that a person have to answer to himself. And who is the one that asks these questions? You're not going to believe. You remember last week parasha when Yaakov Avinu bumped in to Esav? What did Esav ask him? He asked the angels. How many questions he asked them? Three questions. What's the questions? Lemi ata, le'an ata olech, ve'lemi elelach. And we're going to explain each one of us, each one of them. Meaning, in a simple way, if you remember, Akiva ben Ma'ale lomer, istaken b'shlosha dvarim, ve'en ata ba'al yedei avera. If you don't want to make a scene,
you have to remember three things. Today we're going to take it to a different angle, but this, let's remember the first one, the original. The original is the three things that we have to remember in order that always going to be happy, always to be happy, and never have any arrogance. Never, you will never have any arrogance. You will never have any jealousy or temptation to do avarot. If you remember these three things, you kill all the reason of doing sins. Do you know what's the tree? By the way, these trees, Rashi Tevot Melach. You know Melach, salt? You know why do we put salt on the tables? Why do we put salt in the bread? It's two reasons, many, many other reasons, but two reasons that I can tell you right away. The first reason, and the simple one, in the Korban, in the Mizbeach, it was salt. The table for human being is considered to be Mizbeach. Because of that, when you sit next to a table, you have to sit with kavod. You have to eat, not to come with a Bermuda, with a, how do you call it?
Short,
and you know, no cover of the desert. You have the grass all over, and the guy's coming to eat. Rabbi, this is my home. You eat food, it's considered to be like a Mizbeach. The same way that the Kohen Gadol came dressed beautiful when he came to give sacrifice to the Almighty God, you have to respect the table because the table is your panasa. The same way that we're not allowed to throw bread, danger for panasa, right? Danger of money, the same way that you have to respect, okay? Second reason is because the Melach is Rashi Tevot, stand for the three things that a person has to remember. What's the three things? Da me'ayin bata, ve'le'an ata ulech, ulifne mi'ata atid iten, din v'chishbon. A person has to remember, when we come in here tonight and we're speaking about Yeshua, the Yeshua of Chosni Bat Yeshua, וגם כן רחמת כולם, האיש הקשר והישר שנפטר בשום דולם מולו החנוכה, בן מיכאל. רוח השם תנחם בגן עדן, תהיה נשמתם צורה בצורה חיים. When you come into Yeshua, you have to remember the three questions that every day you have to work up with these three questions. מאין באתי? Where I came from? Where I'm going and what I'm doing in between? מאין באתי מטיפס רוחה? I came from a dot. I came from dot. Meaning, many times we're arrogant, you know. You don't know who I am. Don't look at me like that. I'm rich. Come the first question and kill you the whole, all the balloon. The fact that you have building, the fact that, don't ask, you know. Check in Bukhara, who is my family? You know, who's my grandfather? Who are you, Chantarish? Who are you? Don't tell me who is your grandfather, who is your grandfather. Ahmad Kunam, they are amazing people. They are righteous. The question is, who are you? No, don't talk to me like that. You know, Me'ayin batamiti, you came from a dot. We all came from the same dot. And the person said, Le'ayin ata olech? Where are you going out? After 120 years, nobody took the steaks that he ate. How much temptation we have for food? We eat, we eat, we eat. If you're going to make a calculation how much food we eat, especially us being in this beautiful community, the Bukharian community, that we eat, just the oshpelot that we eat in our life, you know how many, maybe you need 5 containers for one person for the oshpelot that you ate, 5 containers. Tell me, a person that died, which usually weight? Usually before a person died, lo alinu v'lo alchem, God forbid, none of you, he becomes sick, and then he becomes skinny because he doesn't eat, right? So skinny. So he leaves the world with maybe 50 to 60 kilo. 100 to 150 pounds. How much food he eats throughout these years? Thousands and thousands of... And nobody took the food with him. Nobody took the car, and nobody took the buildings, and nobody took the house. Le'an ata olech? Why do you have so much temptation? Why do you have so much jealousy? But I want what he have. I mean, you don't take with you nothing. Le'an ata olech? And the last one is, Lifnei mi ata atid iten din v'cheshbon. Remember who you have to come and to be accountable for your actions. A person do sin, when a person steals something, what's the first question that they ask? There's no camera, right? When a person steals, the first thing is looking, There's no camera. Oh, there's no camera, I can still. God forbid, lo aninu. Rabotai, here in the BJCC, we have camera here, and we have camera here. And I will tell you even better. We have the best camera here, and in your house, and in, even in your bedroom. And that camera have, how do you call it, HDDD? How do you call it? HD? Eh? HD. I mean, the best resolution. High definition, zoom, and unlimited memories. And you know which camera is that? The Almighty God. What do you think, that Hashem doesn't see you? You can hide from anyone else, but you cannot hide from Hashem Yitbarach. So this is the three questions that a person have to ask himself on a daily basis. Okay, this is so far. But tonight, I will give you a chidush. And listen to these questions that a person have to. Lemi ata. To who you belong? Me'ayin bata. What is your source? You see, when you remember the first three that I said, usually it leads you to what? To become depressed. Wow, you know, I came from a dot, I'm going to the dot. Wow, balagan. Wow, my life is miserable. So I will give you something to have a smile. Three ways to ask the same question in a different ways. The first question is, where are you coming from? You know what I mean, where are you coming from? Where you coming from is, you see, when Yosef went to make the Avera, when Yosef went to make the Avera, to make the sin with the wife of Potiphar, you remember, we all remember the story. The wife of Potiphar came to seduce Yosef a Tzaddik. She tried so many times until one day, it was nobody home, she catch him in what? And he's begged. Vatitpasir bebegdo vatomar shechva imadi. She catch him in a cloth and she said, come and do the Avera. What Yosef did? He ran away from the cloth. He ran away and, you know, he left the cloth over there. You know why we call begged, begged? Beged is cheating. Beged, betrayed. How do you call beged? Beged meaning? Traitor. Traitor. Traitor meaning, you know, in the country, when you have somebody that is playing like your friend, and is actually giving, become a traitor. Beautiful. Why? You can have zero money in the bank, and outside you look like $1 million. And you drive in a beautiful cars. We all remember this time before we got married, you remember? What a clothes we used to wear before. What a car, the best car, right? You remember the way, which restaurant we choose to take our future wife? The most luxury restaurant. What the shoes we used to have. I mean, the best, why? Because we want her to get to choose us to be married. So even though that we don't have money, thank God we have credit card, we use in any credit card that exists. Visa, MasterCard, American Express, anyone that exists, why to show off? This is what we call beged. Beged minashon buged. A person can be a multimillionaire, and I saw many people like that, that they had so much money, and you're gonna see them, the way that they dress, you can give the guy charity. The guy coming with a t-shirt like that, simple t-shirt, simple, the one that you buy 10, and you get another 20 on the house, just to take it out. You know, the cheapest one costs 25 cents. He come with the t-shirt, no names, the sunglasses. You know the sunglasses that you buy in an airport? The one that $399? You know, $399 sunglasses. And he come in like that with kafkafim? Yes, what do you want? And then look, he said, are you joking with this guy? I'm gonna go to make business? Yeah, I told you, I don't know if I told you. You know why we have Stanford University. It was a guy that went into Harvard University to put his own child. No, this is a true story, you can check it. Not Stanford, Yale. I'm sorry. Cohen Benyaminov, you can check it. He's from Columbia. One of the five Ivy Leagues. You know why do we have Yale University? A guy from Texas boy, you know, came with a
איך זה נקרא בגדיה? בוט, קאבוי בוט. כן, speaking in a slowly way, how are you doing? Good morning, and a heavy accent with the cigar. He's coming in, it looks like a poor man. He's walking in and he wants his child to get into Harvard University. The dean looked at him and said, are you joking? Where are you coming from? The Indians? What's he doing? Get out of here, there's no place for you. Happened to be that this guy was the richest guy in Texas. He left outside and he said, you know what, I'm going to open my own university. He opened, yeah. This is the story, by the way, this is the story. The guy opened it. Beged is from the word boged. Betrayed. She catch him in his own clothing to say, Yosef, this is what you are. Many times, the evil inclination, Yetzirah, is catching us in our own sin and said, this is what you are. You're lazy. You are easy to get anger. This is me. This is you. This is what defines you. Easy to get anger. A lazy boy. A boy that, lo alinu velo lachem, have no power to control his desires. You are Rasha. You are the essence of you. He's bad. What you can do? This is you. Come, Yosef HaTzadik, and teach all of us. No, 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 no. I have nothing to do with my clothing. Lemi ata, to who you belong, והנפש האלוקית מלמעלה היא חלק אלוקה ממעל ממש. Your soul belong to God. To who you belong? To who you belong? To the Almighty God. You don't belong to the evil inclination. You don't belong to the bad that you did. You belong to Hashem. The first question that a person has to ask himself, למי אני שייך? I belong to whom? To my business, to my wife, to my children, to the society, to my family. To who I belong? To my bad character, to my temptation. You don't belong to none of them. You belong to Hashem Yitbarach. What a beautiful answer is that. Beged is from the word betrayed. Don't give the evil inclination to teach you, to convince you that you are bad. At any moment you can change it. Because you belong to Hashem Yitbarach. This is one. Second question is, לאן אתה הולך? Where are you going for? Where are you going to? Where are you going? A person asks you, what do you do? Every day you wake up late. Every day you have excuses. Every day in business you have temptation. Every day you do the same. לאן אתה הולך? רבותיי, a person have to remember. And that pasuk, like I said before, will teach us of us a great message. Me'ashem mitzad egever konanu. I wish that you're going to remember this pasuk. From all this class, you're going to remember this pasuk. La'an ata olech netanel? Where I'm going? I'm going to a place that Hashem wants me to be. That Hashem wants me to be. It was once a person that went into heaven after 120 years. And they showed him a clip, a movie, kind of a movie. And he was in a good mood. And he saw in the movie, every place that he's going is always four steps. Four steps, you know? Four. Two of himself and two steps of the Almighty God. After the movie finished, he had the questions. And he asked the judge upstairs. He says, excuse me, judge, I want to ask you questions. I looked in all the movie, and the whole time that it was easy and good, I saw four steps. When it was difficult part in my life, I saw only two. Where are you, God? Why you didn't stood up over there when I need you the most? Why when I had crisis with my wife, crisis in my business, crisis in my life, crisis in my beriut, I didn't see you? And the answer is, the Almighty God answered him, tipesh, foolish. It was not your two steps, it's my steps. I carry you in that time. I put you on my shoulder. In the tough time, a person has to remember, you know who carries us in our life? Hashem Yitbarach. לאן אתה הולך? I'm not going. Hashem Yitbarach is the one that lead me. So if you miss exit, if you miss flight, you miss a flight. A person that have no faith will get upset.
We'll get upset, we'll sue the company, we'll sue the whole world. We'll scream and shout. A person that have faith will say, wow, thank God I missed this flight. For some reason, Hashem wants me to be here. Why? Either to save me from something, or either just to meet another person that I need to meet. I missed a flight one time. They invite me for Rosh Hashanah to be the main speaker in Florida. And I don't know, I came in, Israelis, we always come in the last minute, and we always believe that we can make it. And you know, I came in, because line by us is not really line straight. We always come, you know, pyramid. Israelis, you know how you know that you're in El Al? Nobody stands straight. Everybody's cutting from all over. So, you know, I thought that I would make it. I made it, and my luggage made it. By the way, my luggage made it. Don't ask me how my luggage made it. The luggage is in Florida, and I got stuck in New York. I got stuck in New York. It was a few hours before Rosh Hashanah, and I had no other flight. Meaning, I lost Rosh Hashanah. The first question is why? Why bad things happen to good people? God, I want to go over there to bring people to teshuvah, to make people closer to religion. Why did I need? Right, Mr. Bela, good question, Mr. Riva, right? Good questions. So why did I lost it? 10 minutes later, after I got relaxed a little, I realized that Hashem Yitbarach is running the world, and not Rabbi Vaknin, and maybe, because deep down, each one of us believes that he is running the world. As much that we're going to talk about Emunah, deep down, we all believe that, you know, it's my way or the highway. I will tell you what to do. I will tell you how to breathe. Rabotai, Hashem Yitbarach, the Almighty God, is the one that's running the world. So I said, you know what? Maybe Hashem wants me to be here. And I'm walking back outside, and I hear Israelis. One guy, I mean, it was three guys, but one guy talking on the phone. He, you know, Israelis, they're not talking quiet, like Chinese and Thailand people. They're also Chinese. I was a rabbi in China. You know, I don't know if you ever ride a subway in China. Over there is no door. The whole train is open. Everything is open. Beautiful trains, but everything is open. And when a Chinese guy is talking, you cannot sleep. Even if you're this kid, hey, Omar, Lee, how you come? How you come? He's like, whoa, how you come? I wake up always, I say, whoa. What's that he's giving? Israelis also, they are not always quiet. The guy is calling on the phone. Actually, you don't understand, we came here. They promised us that they're going to accept us. Nobody came, we have no place to be. He's calling Israel to ask what to do. And I hear, and I said, ah, Bura Olam, now I know why you're here. Now I know why you sent me here, now I know. Ataya Daddy. I pick up my hand and said, Achim Shili, yes, Lachim Akom. You have a place for Rosh Hashanah? My home. My home is your home. It's Hashem home. It's not my home. Hashem home. You come to my house. Uriel, Uriel. They came to the house. They stay Rosh Hashanah. And they literally changed their life to become religious because of it. So maybe I lost a flight to Florida. But I gained 3 souls that came to my house and changed my life. Changed their life. You hear that? It's no coincidence. Where you going? Where Hashem take me. I'm not going. Hashem lead me where I need. If you're going to ask me 20 years ago, if I know that I'm going to become a rabbi in the Bukhara and in such a beautiful community, I will never guess that I'm going to be here. And you know what? I saw in my life the way that Hashem, sometimes you just have to close your eyes and see the way that Hashem is running the world in such a perfect way. When I went to Hong Kong, that I know that I'm going to go to Hong Kong, I went to get married in Israel, and my wife told me, no. We stay in Eretz Israel. The condition of our wedding, my wife is not here. Wow. The condition of our wedding is that we don't leave Eretz Israel. We're going to remain living in Eretz Israel. And you can ask a rabbi, better off? I mean, living in Eretz Israel is not something to compromise. It's the greatest zechut Every time I'm coming to Eretz, I kiss the ground. I'm from the people that kiss the ground every time. The Eretz Israel is not Florida, Miami, Bura Bura or Gehenam. Eretz Israel is the only place that considered to be Kadosh, that the ground is Kadosh. When I'm coming every flight, I kiss the ground. Ve'et afara yechonenu. I kiss the ground. For me, living in Eretz Israel is the greatest zechut. So why am I not in Eretz Israel? Because when you're going to ask me where you're going, I'm not going to tell you I'm going where Hashem take me. I follow the orders of the Almighty God. And if Hashem decides that I need to be in Hong Kong, my wife told me, no, Shalom Bayit. No, no America. I said, okay, Far East. I took my wife, she said, no America. She didn't say no the world. Okay, so I hear what I want to hear. And it was a community over there. We came there for 2 years, a beautiful community. We met close to 10,000 business people every year, and 3,000 people that live in Hong Kong, Jewish people that live in Hong Kong. Amazing, Mordechai, amazing community. And then from there, I went back and I opened yeshiva. And then I came to become a rabbi in the Syrian community for 8 years. Habibi Ayani. Now, what is the chances that Israeli rabbi, Moroccan, will become a rabbi in the Syrian? You know how difficult, you know how locked down the Syrian community is? You know how locked down? They have only rabbi from their own. They don't mix, not marriage-wise and not rabbi-wise. It happened to be that I was a rabbi there for 8 years until I met the Kafi family. And Mrs. Bella, the first time that she met me, she said, Rabbi Vaklin, your destiny is Bukhara. You're on the way to us. Yeah, you remember Mrs. Bella? How many years ago was it? 7 years ago? 7 years before I came, 3 years before, she said, I know, you're going to come to Queens. Prepare yourself. And I'm looking, I will ever leave Brooklyn? Are you joking? You know what's in Brooklyn, to live in Brooklyn? Brooklyn is the closest place to become Eretz Israel. The closest one. Nothing is like Eretz Israel, it's the highest. But after Eretz Israel, the greatest place to live religious wise is Brooklyn. Do you know how many religious people they have over there? You feel at home. Kolelim, yeshivot, shiurei Torah, amazing. What exactly I have to do in Queens? And then I realize that Rabbi Vaklin is not the one that ran in the world. Hashem decides that my soul and these beautiful communities, maybe the greatest community, I'm here for 4 years and I'm in love with this community. Ask me now, I never knew how, why did I need to be in Hong Kong? Why did I need to be? But maybe everything is just to prepare me to this moment. Rabotai, le'an ata olech? Mi ata? Who you belong? Nadir, if somebody asks you who you belong, what's the answer? To Hashem Yitbarach, to the Almighty God. I don't belong to my anger. I don't belong to my temptation. I don't belong to my sin. I don't belong to my laziness. I don't belong to my eyes that watching things that not supposed to. I don't belong to my mouth that speaks Lashon Hara. No, this is traitor. This is beggar. This is external. My internal belongs to who? To the Almighty God. And every morning when we wake up in the morning, what do we say, Mordechai? Neshama shenatata bi teorai. The Almighty God, my soul is pure. Everything outside is external. Have nothing to do with me. I belong to you. One. Second question that Esav asked Yaakov, Le'an ata olech? Where are you going? Where are you heading? What is the answer? Cohen, what's the answer? Where are you going? Where are you going? What is the answer? To the place that Hashem decides me to go. You read that, Mola Israel? You don't go nowhere without the permission of God. And this is what the Pasuk said. Me Hashem mitzade gever konanu. A person has to know that his steps is directed by God. Why you took right and you didn't took left? Why you missed the exit? Why you missed the flight? Why you wake up late? All these things, instead of getting anger and more white hair and issue in Shalom Bayit, because you always blame your wife. But what I have? Tradition. tradition. I just follow tradition to bring my wife. I mean, Adam HaRishon blamed his wife. We continue tradition. Rabotai, you don't have to blame no one. It's all divine. Where you heading? You heading to the places that Hashem take you. And last question is, wow. Ulemi elelach. Ah, oh nice. Gentlemen, ladies, our portion of the week said, V'Yisrael ahav et Yosef, Israel ahav et Yosef, mikol echav, v'yas lo kuton et pasim. Now, the Rogachover said something amazing. Every time the word Israel appear, we're talking about Knesset Israel, the whole Jewish nation. When the name Yaakov come, we're talking only about Yaakov. But when the name Israel come, we're talking about the whole Jewish nation, right? So why the whole Jewish nation choose yourself over the other brothers? What's exactly the problem with the other brothers? Daniel, Dr. Daniel, the Gemara said that a person cannot differentiate it between the child. If you make a wedding, and how do you call it? An elajo, to one child, all the children have to have wedding wear. And now I'm not here to promote elajo. He's doing very good, with me, without me. But I'm just telling you, because you cannot, no. It costs so much. Who cares? You did one child, you have to do the rest. Why? Because if not, deep down you're breaking the child. Deep down you're making a child feel, you know, my wife, when she buy one suit or she buy one clothing, first of all of them have to dress the same. I don't know if you saw my children. Thank God I don't have to, because sometimes she choose colors that is not so good for rabbis. Okay, we're not going to get into details, but you know, my little son, blue color, balagan, pants. The guy's coming with the son of a rabbi. He's amazing, this guy. Okay, thank God I don't have to dress, you know. But usually with my children, she choose all of them the same. Why? Not to differentiate it between the children. Where do we study it from? Yaakov Avinu. Yaakov Avinu made different between the children. How many times they ask you, which child you love the most? And we, being foolish people, we answer the questions. No, he is bright. I love him. I mean, they're all good, but he's so kind. You know what you're doing right now? You create hate among your children. Lo'alenu v'lalachem, after 120 years, don't ever make a will that is going to make a fight in the family. You're going to get the business, sell everything, and give everybody exactly the same. If somebody care for you and handle you, if somebody took care of you, pay them on a monthly basis. Pay them, give them money. But in the will, don't differentiate it among your children. You don't understand what you're doing. Where do we study it from Yaakov Avinu? Yaakov Avinu make one kutonet, one clothing extra, and we went down to Egypt for how many years? 210 years. The worst exile in the world history because of one extra clothing. One extra suit. Do you realize that we're not allowed to differentiate it among our children? So why are you coming? Why the Jewish nation choose yourself? Listen to that, and with that I'm going to conclude. Ladies and gentlemen, we don't understand what's the fight between the brothers to Yosef HaTzadik. What exactly the argument is? Why are you coming to choose Yosef over the brother? Rabotai, it was a huge fight. A huge argument. What's the argument? Olam HaTorah belong where? The world of Torah belong where? In the synagogue or outside? No less. All the brothers said, you want to become a righteous person, you have to be inside. You have to protect yourself. Don't go to Manhattan. Don't go to Bura Bura. Don't go to Cancun. Chas v'shalom, lo aleinu. Don't go to Vegas. Why? Chatanu, avinu, pashanu. They invite me once to come to give lecture in Vegas. I said, no. I said, you're pushing it already. He said, why? I said, maybe I will never come back. So they said, so you know what the answer? It's better for us. We're going to buy one-way ticket. It's much cheaper. I said, no. You know, listen to that. Most of religious people think that religion belongs where? in a synagogue. You want to become kadosh, you want to become taor, you want to become talmid chacham, you want to teach Torah, come to the synagogue. Because of that, all our parents, this is answering other questions. Did you realize that Avraham Avinu, Yitzchak, Yaakov, all the children except Yosef, Moshe Rabbeinu, all of them was shepherd? David HaMelech. Did you know that all of them used to deal with shepherd, with sheep? Did you ever ask yourself, what, diamond business is not good? What exactly happened? Why not jewelry? Why not the clothing? Why not shoes business? Why shepherd? Did you ever ask yourself why all of them were shepherd? Listen to that. Because shepherd is the only way to run away from this world. Where is the sheep usually? In the field. Over there nobody bothers you. Nobody's going with lack of modesty. You don't have to see things that you don't have to see. Nobody speaks Lashon Hara. Over there you're sitting down like in Tzfat and talk like in the morning, and you hear people screaming, Abba! Talk like in the morning. Screaming, they are at Bodedut. Over there you can speak with Hashem, you can be connected, you're running away from this world. This is the opinion of 11 brothers. Actually, in this case, 10. Except Yosef. Yosef said, no. Not only that you're not right, you're losing a great opportunity. I want to become the king of the world. He sees dreams. I will become a king, and I will overrule the world, and the sun and the moon will bend over. And then Oktem said, are you joking? You want to go to become a king in the worst country in the world? The most lowest level of countries, you want to become a king? Yosef said yes. And you know what Yosef did? Yosef a tzaddik. He took religion and he convinced him, he made Brit Milah to all the Egyptians. You know that everybody did Brit. He converted all of them. He teach Torah to the whole world. And not only that he didn't lose Kedusha, he used this world for Kedusha needs. Internet is something very dangerous. Internet is something very dangerous. I believe that there's no rabbi that will promote internet. But if you're wise enough, internet has so much power that if you use it in the right way, you can elevate it to so much Kedusha. So most of the world ran away. Most of the religious world ran away. Locked down, no internet, no TV, no nothing. I'm not saying that it's good to bring it back home. But why not to give classes? Thousands and thousands of people listen to these classes. You can make a person make teshuvah because of one. Why not use this tool and to elevate it to Kedusha? You hear that? The approach of yourself is this way. Don't run away from the world. Use it for your benefits. You don't have to run away, no. The world exists, be with you and without you. Why not to elevate it? Money is a lot of things, a lot of issues we can have. Stealing, lying. But you know what money is doing also? The whole yeshiva was built with money. The whole Olam HaTorah built with donation. So money is good or bad? If somebody asks you money is good or bad, what's the answer? What's the first way? Depends what you do with that. Anything in life that you see. Internet is good or bad, depends what you do with that. You can take and you can download so many classes. You can be connected to the Almighty God in such a high level. Or, you can find the lowest level of Tum'ah in that place. So it all depends on you. Come, Yosef HaTzadik, and said, you know what? I'm not running away. I will not become shepherd. I will become the king, and I will change it to become the greatest. And this is Lemi Elelach. The last question is Lemi Elelach. Rabotai, who you belong to? The answer is to the Almighty God. Where are you heading? Where are you going? Moshe, the answer is where Hashem wanted me to go. Where Hashem take me. Very simple. Hashem carry me from one place to another place. And what do you do in between? What do you do in between? What do you do? You know what I'm doing? I'm taking the physical world and elevate it to Kedusha. you take money and you give charity, you elevate it to Kedusha. You take food and you make a blessing, you elevate it to Kedusha. You take your house and you invite guests, you elevate it to Kedusha. Everything that a person is doing, you can elevate it. Bechol derachecha da'ehu. The Rambam writes, you don't have to serve God only 2 hours a day. Every second of your life that you live, you can make decision in halacha how to serve God in a better way. Where you heading? What do you do? I elevate myself to become much higher and much higher in Torah or mitzvot. Rabotai, I will conclude by saying, the Almighty God, I don't want you Olam Haba. I don't want you Gan Eden. All what I want is, I want you. Hashem Yitbarach, if there's anything that we come here to request, is to request you, to be connected to you, in the highest level, and hopefully with enough faith and trust, in Hashem Yitbarach, the same God that gave us Parnassah yesterday, the same God that gave us Parnassah 2 days ago, the same God that gave us the ability to see, to hear, to speak, and to walk, and to think, and to speak, the same God will continue to give us the same ability to see, to walk, to speak, to have the 248 bones and 365 vein working in our body with Beriyut Shelema Ve'etana. The same God will give us to be successful. We don't have to worry what's going to happen in 2 years or 3 years from now. Because honestly, the past is past. Avar ein atid minayin, ahoveh benatayim. The past is past, the future nobody knows. Enjoy the moment. The moment is now. The moment is this moment, this dekah. This 1 minute is the minute that I am alive. And the same God that gave me that moment will give me the other moment as well. May God will bless us all for coming to the class of Torah, for being connected, to first of all answer the 3 questions that we have on a daily basis, to have the same answer. And second, to fulfill everything that we ever wish and desires. Let us say amen. Rabbi Hanan HaKadosh Baruch Hu.